member of the Labour Party that are calling for the formation of an interim administration and claiming that they are against the swearing in of the president-elect as declared by the Independent National Electoral Commission. And the people behind it are Julius Abure, the former National Chairman of the Labour Party, Kenneth Okonkwo, Obiora Ifo, and Dr. Tanko Yunusa, and we are calling for their arrest and prosecution by the Inspector General of Police for breach of peace. And
hello guys, good morning, good afternoon, good evening. Well, welcome to this YouTube channel. If today is your first time with this channel, make no fear to hit on the subscribe button. If you don't subscribe before, thank you and God bless you. If today is your first time with this Facebook page, Pack Everyone 01, make no fear to like and follow this page for more videos or updates to come your way. My people, wonder shall never end. Obedient, share this video. That's I don't go waste no time. I won't drop video for that. Make una hear from this our enemy. Where he call himself obedient before. Make una hear what he talk. Where this is Labour Party. People waiting to put for inside Labour Party. People will come destroy our money. Make una hear what he talk. He say Peter Obi no get right to stop Tinubu inauguration. He say Peter Obi agitation is not supported. He say Peter Obi cannot be the president of Nigeria. He said that Bola Ahmed Tinubu, where INEC select give us, na he win. This one a person where he call himself Labour Party member for inside Labour Party. Na he they support another party, the BTO party. Ah man, people are desperate in this Nigeria. There's nothing money cannot do. See, Nigeria, I want to tell you something. More we try and get this our mandate. More we get this our mandate. There are a lot of things we need to change for that country called Nigeria. Because what's the apple right now for Nigeria? This could just believe, say, the way the country they go sooner, so they take the wrong country. Violence sooner, they take the road this Nigeria. Yes, because they just feel as they the power, so they can do this on their own, decide on their own. Right now, we'll let them know, say, man, we'll change up for their hand. Guys, make I drop this video for now, make on our watch. Please share this video. Obedient, share this video. Tinubu cannot be the president of Nigeria, it's not possible. All these are papa them, so waiting to put for inside the Labour Party. When I see why Kenneth Okonkwo talk, say they don't get level. What can I draw video for that? Make a year from this guy, mad. He said, Peter Obi, his agitation is not supported. Ha! Man, people are wicked. Watch this video, then when they come back. See you guys later.
Certain individuals claiming to be a member of the Labour Party that are calling for the formation of an interim administration and claiming that they are against the swearing in of the president-elect as declared by the Independent National Electoral Commission. And the people behind it are Julius Abure, the former National Chairman of the Labour Party, Kenneth Okonkwo, Obiora Ifo, and Dr. Tanko Yunusa, and we are calling for their arrest and prosecution by the Inspector General of Police for breach of peace and an act that will undermine the unity of Nigeria. And following series of agitation and call for restraining the president-elect from being sworn in on May 29, 2023, Labour Party hereby allay the fears of Nigerians that the swearing in of the president-elect will not have an impact on the ongoing legal tussle in the presidential election tribunal involving our party, APC, and INEC. You will recall the television interview by the legal nominary, Chifemi Falana, SCN, who explicitly posited the position of the law on the election matter at the tribunal, and Labour Party was in agreement with him because the issue had been properly dissected by the legal jurisprudence, who affirmed that the statement credited to Cardinal Onoyekon may not be feasible, as the current legal tussle may take more than 3 months before it could be finally disposed of. The Electoral Act and Constitution of Nigeria does not give room for vacuum. So whether the president-elect is sworn in or not, there is right to remove him legally if found that he was not duly elected, according to Chifemi Falana. While certain other example, like the 2003 election of Peter Obi and Chris Ikigi, Ahmed Dati, our current vice presidential candidate, and who got elected as a senator, then, and Masari, the outgoing governor of Katsina, the judiciary played the role it was expected of it, and those that lost at the court vacated their seat in spite of spending some time at the seat then. Mr. Peter Obi started afresh, likewise others, and that's why we're having staggered election in some states, including Anambra. Now, let me now delve on the constitutional provision on when the president-elect may not be sworn in, so that most of us, the obedient family, Labour Party family, and the obedient, those calling for war in Nigeria, will know. Section 136 sub 1 of the 1999 Constitution as amended states, if the president-elect died before taking oath of allegiance and oath of office, the vice president will be sworn in as president. The vice president-elect, who is now the president, will nominate a new vice president with an approval of a simple majority of the joint sitting of both the Senate and the House of Rep. Section 136(2) of the 1999 Constitution as amended states, where both the president-elect and vice president-elect die before they are sworn in, the INEC shall immediately conduct an election for the president and the vice president. Now, constitutional provision on when there is a vacancy in the presidency. Section 146 sub 1 of the 1999 Constitution as amended states as follows. Where the office of the president is vacant and as a result of death or resignation, impeachment or permanent incapacity or removal from any other reason, the vice president shall be sworn in as president. While section 146 sub 2 of the 1999 Constitution amended state that where the seat of both the president and vice president become vacant, the Senate president shall hold office for the president for no more than 3 months, within which an election for a new president will be conducted to complete the remaining period. Section 146(3) of the same 1999 Constitution as amended said, the new president elected shall nominate a vice president who shall now nominate a vice president with the approval of the Senate and the House of Rep. The only time the Senate president can hold the office of the president is where both the president and the vice president are incapacitated, and the Senate president can only hold office for no more than 3 months. It became very clear, those people calling, especially Dr. Tanko Yunusa and Kenneth Okonkwo, who are calling that the Senate president should be sworn in, we need to alert the Nigerian police, because if the Constitution says the only condition where a Senate president will hold an office is when both the vice president and the president and vice president are incapacitated, we don't know why they are calling for this. Probably they want to incapacitate the president-elect and vice president-elect. The police will need to do their work on that. Now, what Peter Obi is crying for is not supported by the law. Our law provides that where an election is challenged, the winner will be sworn into the office and will continue to act in that capacity until the hearing and determination of the petition challenging the election. A refusal to swear in the president-elect as president will create a vacuum in the system. Which law above, from President Obasanjo to Yar'Adua to Jonathan to Buhari, this has remained the law and the system. Why should the position change now when the law has not been changed? Our law does not provide for interim president in the circumstance. The only time we had an interim president in Nigeria was Chief Enesoneko, which was a military stunt and not a constitutional procedure. Even Peter Obi has also benefited from the system, being sworn into office irrespective of pending petition at the tribunal. Peter Obi was sworn to office as governor while Andy Uba went to the tribunal to challenge his election. And at no time did anybody say an interim governor should be sworn in. The law has to be complied with, which is to swear in the president-elect. Even though we are not of the same party, but Labour Party believe in the rule of law, and such, that law must be complied with. If anybody wants to challenge the narrative, they will have to change the law, but with what we have now in our constitution today, their demands are not backed up by any law. It is null and void and of no confidence. It is misconceived and show a serious ignorance of the law. Labour Party therefore warn all the obedient to clandestinely parading themselves as LB member and other obedient who may be agitating that the president-elect should not be sworn in to have a rethink, as Labour Party will not support any unlawful means of agitation or change of government violently. We cannot throw the baby away with the bathwater. The same election brought in our candidate who won in the last general election. We have so many House of Assembly, senators, and House of Rep. Now, who want to be judgmental must not be selective. Those who come to equity must come with clean hands. How can the election be discredited for a winner, but credible for the winner among members of the opposition party, including Labour Party? What we should be working for is how to suddenly review our election process so we do have a winner who will be sworn in and who everybody will rally around. The Labour Party will continue to pursue our matter in court only lawfully with all vigor, whether Tinubu is sworn in or not. Finally, Labour Party presently want to announce to Nigeria that we are under the siege of political vampires, political buccaneers, predator and emergency democrats, where some civilian in military camouflage want to conspire with the dictate of uninformed Nigeria to stage a coup d'etat against May 29 Nigeria. That we will not support. And we also want to challenge our presidential candidate that on a moral ground, he needed to be found on the side of law, because we must show to Nigeria that even if victory is given to us at the presidential election petition, at the Court of Appeal or Supreme Court, other candidates will respect it. Therefore, once we want that candidate to respect the decision of the court in our favor, we must also respect the decision of court against us. Thank you very much. Now, also, there are certain situations going on, you know, in Nigeria about the absence of our acting national chairman. We want to place it on record that because we are lawful and we do not want any skirmishes, Baba presently will now begin to appear in court on behalf of the Labour Party, while our presidential candidate will now be standing in for himself as the presidential candidate. Because in that court, before election petition tribunal, what we have is Peter Obi and Labour Party. So, for Labour Party, the only recognized body that will not be representing Labour Party is Alhaji Lamidi Apapa. Any other person there is an impostor, and this will now show to the whole world and the court that Baba Apapa, Alhaji Lamidi Apapa, is the national chairman of our party, and we shall now appear in court. And on any adjournment date now, Alhaji Lamidi Apapa, you know, will come to court. Also, what we are now telling the Federal General of Police is this: all these antics to surveillance Nigeria is being carried out at the headquarters of the Obidate campaign organization. It is not from Labour Party Secretariat. So the security agency should beam their searchlight on that party secretariat between now and May 29, so that the people will not conduct themselves in an act that like to copy your peace in Nigeria. And I also want to warn or admonish with the opposition. Let me congratulate Governor Adeleke of Osun, the Senator Adeleke, Ademola Adeleke of Osun State, for his victory yesterday at the Supreme Court. But also at the same time, with the opposition, we need to be very careful, because no member of the opposition has now condemned the judiciary for giving victory, delivering that victory to the PDP in Osun State. I didn't mean it went otherwise now. A lot of opposition parties will be crying wolf all around that, oh, judiciary has compromised. We should stop insulting our judicial system. We should stop insulting our judges simply because we only want opposition to celebrate when victory are given to us. It is very wrong. So, Senator Ademola Adeleke, Labour Party is congratulating you, and we wish you well, you know, in your tenure, you know, as a duly elected executive governor of Osun State. And all opposition, please, whatever decision of the election presidential tribunal in Abuja and Supreme Court, we must respect it, because no political party in the opposition, like I said, has come out now to discredit that judgment because it's opposition. Judiciary is not about opposition. Judiciary is all about Nigeria, for Nigeria and by Nigerians. Thank you.